Dear children, welcome to the SIPMINA channel conducted by the Zonal Education of Piliyandhura. Today, I am going to discuss with you the Test 8 English Paper 1. It's a writing a paragraph. The objective of this test is assess the ability to write a paragraph on a given topic. Technique is free writing. The marking criteria is like this. For the content, you will get 2 marks. For language, 3 marks. Altogether, you can get 5 marks for this test. The word limit should be between 40 to 50 words. Sometimes you can exceed up to 60 also. There, you should write only one paragraph. If you write more than one paragraph, they won't mark the second paragraph. So you have to consider, because you have to write only one paragraph. Then next one, you better write simple sentences. Don't write complex sentences when you write a paragraph for test 8. In this question, the tense and the punctuation marks are very important. So that will count as the language. If the tense and the punctuation marks are there, you will get full marks for the language. Now look at these topics. How I spend my weekend. The verb is spend. It is in present tense. So when you write the paragraph, you have to use present tense to describe how I spend my weekend. Second one. How I spent my last weekend. The verb is in past tense, spent. So children, you have to use the past tense to write about how I spent my last weekend. The next one, trees are our friends. What is the tense you can use for that? Because trees are everywhere, so you have to use present tense. Or sometimes you can use present continuous also. Next topic is a visit to a historical place. That place you have already visited. So you have to use the past tense to write about a visit to a historical place. The next topic is let's keep our environment clean. So what is the tense you have to use? The environment is with us. So you have to use the present tense as well as the present continuous tense to describe let's keep our environment clean. The next point is the sentences should be grammatically correct. So I am going to show you some examples of sentence structures. First one, I help my friends. What is I there? I is the subject. Help is the verb. My friends is the object. So normally when we write sentences, there should be a subject, a verb, and an object. That is called SVO. Second sentence, trees give us shade. So what is the subject there? Trees. Verb, give. Now there are 2 words, us and shade. Trees give us. So us is a direct object because trees give us. Trees give us what? Trees give us shade. So that is also an object, but it is indirect object. So in this sentence, there are 2 objects. What is the first one? Direct object. And the second one is indirect object. Third one, we watch television daily. What is the subject there? We. Verb, watch. Television, object. Then what about that word, daily? So how often do we watch television? We watch television daily. So it is the way of doing the activity or the action. So it should become an adverb of the sentence. So yes, other than subject, verb, object, you can add so many words to the sentence to make it more complex. But there should be always, it should be, there should be subject, verb, and object. Sometimes you can write sentences using the subject and the verb also, like birds fly. That is also accepted. But here, of course, you must consider about the SVO pattern. Next sentence, children play cricket in the playground. So what is the subject there? Children. Verb, play. Object is cricket. What is the other part? In the playground. It starts with a preposition. So we call it a prepositional phrase. It starts with the preposition and there are some words added to that. So in a sentence, we can add a prepositional phrase also. Now there are some steps to follow when you write a paragraph. Now there are three steps to be followed. First one is the topic sentence. Second one is support sentences. Third one is concluding sentences. What do you mean by the topic sentence? Now you will be given a topic for test 8. Normally they give two topics. You have to select out of two topics which is easier for you. So you have to consider about the topic and write the topic sentence. Now for example, if you are asked to write about my best friend, how are you going to write the topic sentence? You can write like this. My best friend is Sunimal. Like that. That is the topic sentence. Then support sentences. So you have to support your support with some ideas to help the topic sentence. Now, if you write about my best friend, as I said earlier, my best friend is Sunimar. Then you can add about the things about Sunimar. Now he is tall. He is very kind-hearted. He always helps the other students in the class. He is very clever. Like that, you can add about Sunimar, which supports the topic sentence. Then the last sentence is the concluding sentence. That means you have to end up your paragraph with the sentence. But it should not repeat the first sentence as you wrote for the topic sentence. So normally, the examiners are expected about 5 sentences for this paragraph writing. I think 5 sentences would be enough for the paragraph. You can write more than that, but you can't exceed the word limit. If you exceed the word limit also, you will lose marks for the paragraph. So you have to keep it in mind. Don't exceed the word limit. If you write less than the word limit, of course, no harm. If you exceed the word limit, you will lose some marks. Now here, I am going to show you a small paragraph. It was given in 2017 ordinary level examination, paper 1, test 8. The topic is, what are good habits? Good habits are practices that help us to lead a good life. For example, getting up early and starting work with a fresh mind is a good habit. Saying thank you when we want to show our gratitude and to say sorry, to express our regret for a wrong action done, are also good habits. There are good health habits such as washing our hands before meals and brushing our teeth twice a day. We must inculcate good habits like these from our childhood. So can you guess what is the topic sentence in this paragraph? I have already underlined the first sentence, that is, good habits are practices that help us to lead a good life. So here that is a topic sentence. What about the rest of the sentences? Now they describes what are the good habits. Now, for example, getting up early and starting work with a fresh mind is a good habit. Saying thank you when we want to show our gratitude and to say sorry to express our regret for a wrong action done are also good habits. There are good health habits such as washing our hands before meals and brushing our teeth twice a day. All those sentences support the topic sentence. That means they describe what are the good habits. Now look at the last sentence. We must inculcate good habits like these from our childhood. What is it? Now it is not connected to the topic sentence, but it gives us an advice to do good habits. We must inculcate good habits like these from our childhood. We have to practice good habits from our childhood. So that is the structure, or that is the way of writing a small paragraph within the word limit. Now, I went through some of the O-level examination papers. Normally, they give very small topics. Each and every child can attempt, because at least they can write one or two sentences, whether it is grammatically correct or incorrect. They can write because the topics are very simple. So first one I have selected, a journey by train. What is the tense that you have to use to describe a journey by train? Because you have already visited. You have already gone by train. So you have to use past tense to describe a journey by train. Second one, the place where I live. Still you are living, so you can't use past tense or future tense. You just use the simple present tense, or sometimes you can use continuous tense also. Third one, the book that I like most. So what is the tense that you can use for that? There, you have already read the book. You may have read so many books. Out of all the books, you have to select the most favorite book or the book that you like most. So you have to use the past tense. Number four, what do you do during your free time? Which tense can be used for this? What do you do during your free time? That means you have to use simple present as well as present continuous tense. That means is, are, am, verb plus ing. Number five, trees are our friends. What is the tense can be used for this? Trees are around us. They are living. So we can use simple present tense. Next topic, the importance of water. Again, we are talking about a valuable resource. So you have to write about it using the simple present tense. Next topic, a visit to a fair. What about the topic and the tense you have to use? A visit to a fair. You have to write after visiting the fair. So you have already visited the fair. So you can describe what you saw, with whom did you go there, what did you buy, and whether you like the place or not. So for those things, you have to use past tense. Last one, I have selected, how you celebrated your last birthday. The verb is celebrated. It is in past tense. So you have to describe what you did for your last birthday. For that, you have to use past tense. So I think now you may have got some ideas about test 8 in English paper 1. In schools also, you may have done several, you may have written several paragraphs with your teachers. So I hope this will enough for your knowledge. I hope that you will be able to get through your O-level examination with good results. Best of luck. I am Mrs. S.L. Karunaratna, in service advisor English, Zonal Education Office, Piliyandala.